What does it mean for you to be a part of a global phenomenon like Game of Thrones?
It's a wild ride. I mean, it's so much fun because I was such a fan of the show and the books, like previous. And so it was very surreal. Like, it took me a long time to stop pinching myself and being like, oh my God, because I would see sets and be like, oh my gosh, it's the wall. Or, oh my God, this is Khaleesi's like hallway that she shoots in. And so it's still, and I still feel very excited about that stuff. And but you know, it's like anything, like once you're doing it, it's like any job and you just kind of immerse yourself in the character and the world of, and then it's not till later that you start remembering like how big it is. Well, I play Obara Sand, who's the eldest of the Sand Snakes, who are Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper's bastard daughters, and they've all been raised fiercely and lovingly by their father to believe that they can do absolutely anything they want. And Dawn's a pretty safe part of the world of Westeros, really. Like, they kind of run on their own. They have their own ruler. They kind of don't play into the rest of the politics that go on. And it's always sunny, and people are a bit more free, just a bit more free in life in general down there. And so I was really interested in playing one of these girls because, one, as a fan of the books, I always thought if there was one place that I'd like to live in, it would be Dawn. Like, it kind of seemed like the most appealing place to live, and you've got the highest chance of kind of living a longer life as well. What attracted me to playing Obara was the fact that, like, her strength, and there's something about her, and not just her physical strength, but also the fact that she's the eldest of all these girls, and there's a huge responsibility on her part to lead them, especially once her father's died. And how do you portray that via someone who's quite tough and probably wouldn't cry, but also takes on the role of looking after her sisters immediately? The series is like really gearing up toward, I mean, I get the sense as a viewer that we're gearing up toward a great battle for the throne, essentially. And we've lived with these characters and in their worlds for a really long time now. And you think, I mean, they've like thrown so many crazy things at us, like right from the get-go, that you think as a viewer that you'll get used to it. And then, like, yeah, the Jon Snow, like, death scene, you're like, whoa. I mean, I'd read the books, but you're not expecting it in that way, and to like visualize it. And I think because you start getting invested in the television show as well, you start thinking, oh, maybe they'll give us a chance as fans to keep stuff that we, you know, maybe change the plot a bit. And so, I mean, I'm really enjoying it, and I trust inherently the storytellers. Like, the nice thing about coming into the show, like once it was already established, was that I got a sense that like the showrunners, like they really know, they really understand their vision and where they're heading with it. So I'm looking forward. I mean, everyone wants to know about Game of Thrones season 6 spoilers, but I'm in the same boat. Like, I'm such a fan of the show, and even though I'm in it, like, it's impossible to get any information even from our side of the fence. And so I'm trying to get like what fans think about what's going to happen, like what are their theories on where the show's heading. And so there's been some interesting things that I'd never considered.
Have you got a message, I guess, particularly to Thrones fans before you leave us?
Unbowed, unbent, unbroken.